Hello and welcome to this CorelDRAW Graphics Suite 2019 Windows tutorial. In this tutorial we'll be covering non-destructive bitmap effects, a cool new effect that works very similar to the Illustrator effect menu and appearance panel. As is the case with Photoshop or Illustrator, these effects are totally non-destructive. Let's explore these exciting possibilities in this vector artwork in CorelDRAW. I'm going to twirl down the layer elements for this and you'll see that it's a relatively complex piece of artwork. But if you name your objects, it makes it really, really easy to find elements. So I've gone and searched for beam and you'll see that it brought up the UFO object. And if I twirl down, you can see I can eyeball the beam on and off to make sure that I've got the right object. We're going to soften out the edges of this beam to make it behave more like natural light. So we'll head over to the new FX button that you'll find on the Properties Docker, and from the plus icon in the middle of that Docker, we're going to head over to Gaussian Blur. We're going to go ahead and preview the Gaussian Blur by adjusting it first and then clicking OK. So that's looking pretty good. You'll see that that appears in our Properties Docker. Next, we'll go ahead and apply an adjustment. A hue saturation lightness adjustment in this case, and that's going to give us a really cool way to adjust color. So we've gone and made it more purple at the behest of the client, and let's assume that the client then changes his or her mind. We can simply click on the little pencil icon to invoke the dialog once again and make the changes we want. In this case, we'll make it more cyany blue to fall in line with the sky. Let's go ahead and click OK on that. Now let's explore some of the cool 3D effects that ship with CorelDRAW. Once again, I'm going to head to the Objects Docker and I want to search for Rectangle because I'd like to work with a base rectangle which acts as the background in this artwork. We're going to head over to Effects once again, and this time we're going to choose 3D Effects and Page Curl. Once the page curl dialog opens, we can then go ahead and tweak it. So it's running too deep, I'll make it shallower and a little flatter from the height as well. So I've gone for like 27 and 15 respectively. If I wanted to change from one side to the other, simply click on the icon and hit the OK button.